Hey friends, you probably know that Azure Container Registry enables you to store and manage container images securely. But did you know it can also be used as a part of your DevOps pipelines? Jeremy Likness is here to show me how ACR can manage your images and even build them for you today on Azure Friday. Hey friends, I'm Scott Hanselman and it's Azure Friday. I'm here with Jeremy Likness and we're going to talk about Azure Container Registry within the context of .NET and applications. How are you, sir?
I'm doing fantastic. Enjoying the last bit of summer here in the Pacific Northwest before it rapidly descends into winter.
Or I was thought you were going to say it rapidly descends into chaos as all the kids go back to school.
There is that too.
All right. So Azure Container Registry just keeps getting better and better.
It's an incredibly useful tool. And the reason why I wanted to talk about that and bring this here is because of some of the ways that it's helped me out with development. It's actually interesting because I'm going to show you a way to take advantage of Azure Container Registry to build Docker images. And I don't even have Docker installed on my new laptop.
So hang on, you don't need Docker to use containers.
You don't. With Azure Container Registry, it's more than just a private repository. So, you know, some of the advantages are it's under your control. You can secure access to containers. They're stored encrypted. So you've got that locked down for your corporate images, if you will. But another advantage is this feature called Tasks, which allows you to leverage the cloud to build these containers.
I'll see it. I'll believe it when I see it.
Okay. Well, let me show you what I've created here. I went ahead and set up a container registry called AZ Friday. And if we navigate into the repositories, which is where the actual images are, you can see there's no result. So I don't have anything here yet. What I did was I invested some time, sweat, some deep thought, and I created this application that features a class that greets, and then a console app that calls that class to greet container world. So This is a very high-end application.
It's pretty sophisticated. I don't know if that's going to scale.
Yeah, we'll have to find out in a second. But what I want to do, so I can obviously run, build, do things with this, but I want to get this into Docker. And like I said, I've got my new laptop and I haven't installed Docker Desktop yet. So what do I do? The first thing I'm going to do is inside of Visual Studio, there's this very handy feature that you can right click, add Docker support. And what that will do is it will take a look at my project. I'm going to go ahead and just target Linux and it'll generate a Docker file. So I've got this nice, lovely Docker file here that has everything needed to build the project. The problem is I don't have Docker, so I have no way to build it locally. So what I'm going to do is drop to a command line. And we'll go ahead and go into a window. Well, actually, I'm going to use Git Bash because this is what I tested it on. And this is Azure Friday Fun. Let me double check. Yes, Azure Friday Fun. And the way that Docker support works in Visual Studio is it sort of assumes you're at the root of the project. So even though I'm not in the console application, I'm going to run it from here and I'm going to drop a command in so that you can save watching me fumble with some typing. I'm just going to go ahead and paste this in. But this is a fairly straightforward command. This is AZ. That's the Azure command line interface.
Okay.
ACR means Azure Container Registry. And then I'm asking it to build. And I'm telling it what I want to build is a container in the repo AZ Friday called GreetMe. This points to the actual name of my Azure Container Registry, which is AZ Friday. This is where the Docker file is. So if you remember, I created the Docker file in the console app. So I'm going to GreetMe Docker file. And dot is just the context that it uses, that it basically starts to pull files in order to build the container. Okay. So I'm going to go ahead and let that run. And what's going to happen in this scenario is it's going to take the context that I gave to it, pull all the files and upload them to the cloud. Then it's giving me logs that are streaming from the cloud, showing it pulling the different layers that it needs, because Docker containers have layers in them. There's a .NET Core layer, there's a layer on top of that, so on and so forth. And eventually it's going to build my project and create my project layer.
Okay.
So we'll let that run through. You can see it's halfway.
I got confused a second though, because I was thinking to myself, well, hang on, who's building the source? But what happened was the build is happening in Docker. Like the SDK exists in Docker. Who's building it? Docker is building it. It's just that you don't have Docker. You're doing a remote build of this. You're using the Docker in the cloud, and ACR is your engine.
That's right. And this is incredibly useful if you're, you know, looking to build images or even layer images that you don't have support from on your local machine, or you want sort of a clean build environment, because this spins up a clean environment that just pulls the context from your machine and creates the build. So it says it's done. Let's go ahead and check it by coming in here, and we're going to refresh this. And now we can see that we've got this AZ Friday greet me. So it's created the container for me. The other nice thing about this container, now if I had Docker on my system, or if I go to a system that has it, I can pull down this image with proper credentials and run that. But let's say I want to spin it up and run it. And again, I don't have Docker on my machine, so I need a place to make that happen. This works hand in hand with Azure Container Instances, which is a service in Azure that will basically allow you to one-off run containers. And, you know, a lot of use cases for that are containers that maybe have web workloads, so it has support for generating unique DNS. I'm obviously using just a console application, but let me go ahead and show you. I seem to have a knack for exposing credentials on this show, but again, I'm going to delete this all. But I want to show you just the steps to get a credential. Now, what you would do in a script to prevent this from being captured or intercepted by someone is you would put this into a variable, or you would store it as a secret, obviously, so there's no access. But this is how I can go in and ask for the automatically generated credential to log in. So now that I have that, I've got two steps. The first thing I want to do is create a running instance of the container that I just built in the cloud. And I'm going to paste this in, and then I'll explain it while it's running. So what we're doing is creating a container. We're giving it the name Azure Friday. And it didn't grab my next one, so it's asking for the password. So we just take this here and paste this here and hope this works. Otherwise, I've got a multi-line that I can paste in.
I see. So you could have piped that through the whole thing in one line, right?
Right. Yeah. Yeah, I could have flexed some stronger command line foo, but I'm keeping it nice and simple. So slow wins the race. But so I gave this a name for my running container, and I'm being very original in this and calling everything Azure Friday. Telling it what resource group to create the container in, telling it what image it's creating. This is the AZ Friday that we just created, and giving it a blah, 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 giving it a password. And it just completed, basically. It's telling me that container ran.
Okay.
So now I have a container. I want to actually execute a command on that container. So I'm going to use the same thing, container, except this time I'm going to do exec. Again, the resource group, this is the name I gave it up here. And this is the command, .NET run, because I have a .NET application stored inside that container. This is not going to do anything very interesting for me here, because I haven't piped it to my local console. It's actually running in the cloud. But if I come back into the cloud and I navigate into my resource group, we should see a container instance right here. And if we go into that container instance, there are logs. Let's see. Let me scroll down. Oh, there we go. Containers. So here's my container. Here's my logs.
Mm-hmm.
And you can see that it ran that right there in the cloud.
Very cool. Docker without Docker.
Docker without Docker. And I use this personally. I wanted to show this because it also allows you to use these containers as part of a build pipeline.
Mm-hmm.
So I've got a blog that is a static website generator. It uses something called Hugo, which is Go of all things. But this basically takes Markdown. And then from that Markdown, you can use this tool called Hugo to generate HTML from mm-hmm. the Markdown. And then I upload that into file storage. I have a static website configured in Azure, and that powers my blog. So if you look at this, I've got a Dockerfile. And the nice thing about this is I don't have to deal with Hugo locally. Like, I don't have to keep track of pulling down new versions. Anytime I want to grab a new version of Hugo, I can basically bump the version number in my Dockerfile, generate a new Docker image, and run that image. So I'm not dealing with install, uninstall, replace, or anything locally. So this is just the definition to create that image. Then I have a build pipeline. Now, this is using Azure DevOps pipelines. This could be done in GitHub Actions as well. But what you'll see here is I've got a step called login. And that step is the only thing I need, because when I configured the step, I put the secret in of what the login credentials are to log into that Azure Container Registry.
Mm-hmm.
Here, I'm just prepping the Git source because it's using something called submodules. But this is where I actually run it. I do this Docker run. I tell it to remove it after it's done running. I don't need to keep it. And then inside that Docker image is Hugo, and I'm mounting the repository path, this working directory, that has my Markdown files in it. And then once this step is done, I publish the artifacts. And what that ends up with is a pipeline that looks like this that pulls this down. Now, the reason I did this is I could have installed Hugo as part of the build process, but pulling down the Hugo releases took a very long time. So my continuous integration took longer than I wanted to. So then I figured out that I'm not changing the version every time I run this. So what I can do is package it in a container, keep it stable. If the versions run away from me and I don't keep up, that's okay, because in my container, I've got the version I know works. And then that quickly gets pulled down in this cloud run, generates all the pages and everything, and then deploys it to it. So it's very seamlessly integrated into my build pipeline.
And that volume mounting thing, I think, is the most significant part. Like, it took me a moment to figure that out. The idea that the container exists for a moment, it does some work, and then it goes away. So what is it doing the work on? And you saw that it was doing the work on your /user/site folder, generating your stuff. That's the persistent artifact. That's the thing that stays when Hugo comes and goes away. And that's you're left with an artifact that wasn't inside the Docker container. The Docker container acted on it via that volume mount in the cloud there, which is really cool.
That's right. And that's how I experiment with new languages. When I was learning Go, instead of installing Go locally, I pulled down a Go container, mounted it to where my source was, and the output of the Go project, I can target Windows and run it on Windows, or target Linux and run it on Linux. But I don't have to set up that whole environment. I can just bring down the container and I'm good to go.
Very, very cool. And Azure Container Registry has been out for a while. This is a thing that people can do right now. So if you are, whether you're familiar with Docker or not, or even if you have a machine that isn't capable of running Docker, you can tap into the power of containers today using the power of the cloud. Cool. I'm learning all about the Azure Container Registry and how we can use it to build .NET Core apps or Go apps or any kind of app that makes me happy today on Azure Friday.
Hey, thanks for watching this episode of Azure Friday. Now I need you to like it, comment on it, tell your friends, retweet it. Watch more Azure Friday.